This is Huta. As one of the most popular Genshin Impact characters in terms of not only her character design and her bubbly personality, but her amazing DPS potential as well, Huta is definitely a fan favorite Genshin Impact character for many good reasons. But I hear you say, is she really worth my precious Primo gems? What's stopping me from maining Yoimiya or something? Now, as a proud Huta main for a couple of years now, I've prepared a series of key points and reasons as to why I believe Huta is absolutely worth it. Timestamps will of course be available in the description. By the end of the video, you should be convinced that Huta is worth every Primo you throw at her. It's never been easier to build Huta, and she, in my eyes, is an awesome free-to-play single-target DPS who has tons of potential if you're willing to go for C1 or Staff of Homer. But even without C1 or Homer, Huta by herself is relatively easy to build and is relatively free-to-play friendly. A 4-piece Crimson Witch is generally the most preferred artifact set for Huta, and luckily you can use the Strongbox to get even more Crimson Witch pieces, making it even easier to build her. Although, if you are struggling or you would just rather opt for an alternative set, a 4-piece Shiminawa works really well. As a general guide, you want to be aiming for crits, elemental mastery, and HP for stats on these artifact sets. Her teams are easy to build and don't require a ton of investment. Huta is extremely strong with hydro supports that proc vaporize, so having Xingqiu or Yalan is a must. Xingqiu is relatively easy to build anyway and doesn't require a ton of investment to be strong with your Huta. If you stack energy recharge on him, he'll be excellent with Huta. Since his burst is super strong with Huta, procking vaporize literally all the time, so it's good to try and have his burst up as much as possible. If you have Yalan and Xingqiu, you can double vaporize for even more damage potential. Popping Xiangling or Sucrose on your team isn't a bad idea either if you want to have more DPS potential, and of course you cannot go wrong with Bennett either. And finally, having a shielder on your team is almost essential for Huta, unless you want to be playing Toho and trying to dodge every attack in the game, as you want to be getting up close and personal with your enemies. Since she is a single target DPS that needs to be up close and personal, spamming charge attacks to do lots of damage. Zhongli is great, but any other 4-star shielders are good options as well. You could go for a Cryo Shield from Diona or Layla, or a Pyro Shield from Toma. The majority of characters that make up a good Huta team are relatively easy to obtain since they're usually just all gonna be 4-stars, and they really don't require a ton of investment to build, making it easier than ever to get a good Huta team. Her C1 is absolutely insane, and Staff of Homer is an excellent option for more damage potential. Huta is perfectly fine at C0, and she excels with 4-star weapons, such as Dragon's Bane, Deathmatch, or Vivonia's Lance. Just think of her C1 and Staff of Homer as added DLC for Huta. That just makes her stand out as an even stronger main DPS. C1 allows Huta to dash without consuming any stamina, which means you can just sit there and spam charge attacks, either dodging enemy attacks or with a shield, tanking that damage and charging the enemy head on. This opens up the opportunity for Huta to output even more damage, even more quickly. And of course, Staff of Homer, an absolutely insane weapon that grants an additional 66% crit damage bonus. With weapon substats that are practically made for Huta's kit, these are nice added bonuses that make Huta even more stronger than she already is, but these are by no means essential. Her awesome character design, as well as her personality. Huta has one of the most unique character designs in the game, with her signature director's hat, her long brown twin tails, and of course those amazing eyes. Her character design absolutely stands out. Her cheeky personality and her iconic voice lines have become staple parts of what makes her such an iconic character, and what makes her so popular in the Genshin community. It's really important to pull for a character that you actually like, so if you love her cheeky personality and her awesome outfit and design, you should totally pull for her. I mean, why not? So, in conclusion, yes, Huta is absolutely worth it. She's an excellent single-target DPS that thrives off of the vaporize reactions from her hydro supports and from a solid shield character. She's relatively straightforward and easy to build, allowing her to be very free-to-play friendly with solid free-to-play weapon options and build options. Her constellations and signature weapon are broken and make her even stronger than she already is. And of course, her character design and personality make her more than worth it. Comment below if you think Hu Tao is worth it, and let me know why you think she is worth it or why you think she isn't worth it. Thank you so much for watching, and I really hope this video has convinced you to swipe for the Pyro Queen. Make sure to subscribe if you want to see more Genshin Impact videos such as this one. What?